Penguin Random House Audio presents Mystery Theater, Volume 2, hosted by Christopher Lee.
Mystery Theater presents
This is Christopher Lee, the host of Mystery Theatre. Please remain calm. Words to the wise in any crisis. Whether chasing down a criminal or evading the law, a clear head is mandatory. The best advice is to avoid stress, but sometimes that seems impossible. Too much stress, and it can take a toll on the ticker. We'll hear all about that in our weird circle story, The Telltale Heart. Prior to that, though, it's good guys versus bad guys on Gangbusters. And to round things out, we'll rocket off into distant space on Dimension X. Ready? The stories begin in just a moment. Gangbusters dramatized closed cases from the files of the FBI. It was presented in cooperation with police and federal law enforcement departments throughout the United States, glorifying J. Edgar Hoover's G-Men. Time now for Appointment with Death on Gangbusters.
Now, Gangbusters, presented in cooperation with police and federal law enforcement departments throughout the United States. The only national program that brings you authentic police case histories.
Tonight, Gangbusters presents the case of the appointment with death, when a courageous policewoman waited for a deadly killer whom police didn't even know.
Gangbusters has asked the Honorable Frederick H. Block, Assistant United States Attorney for the Southern District of New York, to narrate tonight's case.
Thank you, and good evening, Gangbusters listeners. Let's start tonight's case in a second-floor room of a dingy rooming house near the bay section of a large eastern city. It was 5 o'clock in the morning, and persistent pounding on the door of Vicky Chester was needed to awaken her. She was by trade a night spot hostess and had retired only an hour before. For a moment, Vicky sat on the edge of the bed. Then, as the door pounding persisted, she slipped on a light negligee and went to the door.
Oh, all right, take it easy. 5 o'clock in the morning. Oh, who is it?
Come on, let me in.
Who is it?
Know me.
Well, then a fine chance you got. I'd think twice before I let in somebody I know. Now, it's 5 o'clock. Go on away. I got a lot of sleep to catch up on.
I'm a friend of Pinky's.
Oh. Yeah?
That's right. Come on, open up.
Pinky who?
Waldo. Pinky Waldo.
Just a second. Come in.
Oh, thanks. Thanks a lot.
Excuse me for not being more formally dressed.
Don't bother me any.
Company was the last thing I expected at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Well, Pinky's sort of a magic word around here, huh?
Pinky and I meant a lot to each other. Did you see him in? Were you cellmates or something? How's he look?
I didn't even know Pinky was doing a bit until I tried to look him up tonight.
Oh?
You see, Pinky owes me a lot. He said if I ever got to this burg, it'd pay off. Looks as if I got to town too late.
Yeah, about a year too late. Or about 3 years too early, whichever way you want to look at it. Now, go on. I don't get much sleep as it is.
Did Pinky ever mention Slim to you?
Slim?
Yeah.
You want Slim?
I'm Slim.
Well, sit down, Slim. Make yourself at home. Listen, if it weren't for you, I'd never even have met Pinky. He'd have been stuck away in some can in West Virginia.
It was in Ohio.
Yeah, that's... Say, who told you about me?
I heard about you.
Well, couldn't you wait until noon or sometime? Do you have to go pounding on doors at this hour? And incidentally, how'd you manage to get in the downstairs door? That's always locked.
I managed. Ain't that enough?
Yeah, I guess it is. What'd you want with Pinky?
I'm broke.
Well, don't look at me. I ain't no good for a touch.
No, it's not a touch I'm looking for. I just want somebody with connections to get me a heater.
Oh.
Who do you know?
Listen, Slim. You look like a nice guy, but I don't want to get mixed up in anything.
Well, what are you going to get mixed up in? All I want you to do is to tell me where I can get my hands on a gun, cheap.
Well, I...
Now, look. I'm trying to make enough to get to Arizona. There's a good deal waiting for me there. I had a bundle, but it was chump enough to get in a crap game in Jersey City. Took my last nickel to come here and look up Pinky.
Well, Pinky can't do you no good now, not from where he's sitting.
No, but you can. Come on, now, how about it? Where can I get my hands on a gun?
All right, okay. I work at a joint called the Barrel over on...
Yeah, I know. I was there. It was closed.
Well, they got laws about closing, you know.
What about the heater?
You come around to the Barrel about 10 o'clock tonight. There's a guy I'll introduce you to.
He can take care of me?
If I recommend you, yeah.
Good.
You know, you ain't bad looking, you know.
I don't want to waste any time.
How long are you going to be around here, Slim?
Not any longer than I can help it.
Oh, yeah. Arizona.
You're sure that this connection can furnish me a gun?
Relax, Slim. You'll get your heater. Just come around to the joint tonight.
Listen, Vicky, I got no more dough to spend on drinks. Where is this clown?
You're always in a hurry, Slim. Sit still. He'll be here.
You're sure that he can take care of what I want?
You'll get to Arizona. Don't... Uh-huh. Didn't I tell you to have patience? There he is.
Him?
Yeah, him.
You don't look much like an operator.
Well, what do you care how he looks as long as he's got the goods? Wait till I give him the... Oh, he spotted me. Here he comes.
When I give you the high sign, blow.
Listen, you don't have to tell me. I don't want to get involved in any deal.
Hello, Vicky. How goes it? Selling lots of rat gut for the house?
I sell my share. Jack, Slim.
Hi.
Sit down, Jack.
Thanks. My feet are killing me.
Jack.
Yeah?
Slim's a friend of Pinky's.
Ah, you don't say.
I do say.
Well, any friend of Pinky's a friend of mine. Put it there, Slim.
Slim's got some business for you, Jack.
What can I do for you?
Look, boys. You'll excuse me. The boss is getting peeved, my sitting at one table so long.
Yeah, go ahead, kid. And thanks.
For what?
For a lot of things.
Okay. I'll float around later.
Nice girl, that Vicky. Sweet as they come.
We could talk about that all night.
Not me. Early to bed, early to rise. It's my motto. What can I do for you, Slim?
I want a heater. Cheap.
Cheap.
You heard me.
What I got was all hard to come by.
Well, what have you got?
Anything you want. I aim to please.
What for around 20 bucks?
20 bucks?
Yeah, that's all I'm going to spend.
Well, I got an old beat-up Colt 38 special. It ain't much good.
I'll take it.
I wouldn't recommend it to my worst enemy.
I said I'll take it.
Okay. The customer is always right.
That's what you always say, huh?
Always. When do you want it?
Right now. Let's go.
You're in an awful hurry. Slim, ain't that right?
Yeah, that's right. Now, where's the gun? Gotta make me some dough beginning tonight.
Why rush? Haste makes waste. Why don't we have a drink on it?
Come on. Let's get the gun.
Okay. You're the doctor.
You say we take a turn up 80th, Sarge?
Sure, Ed. Up and back, and we'll call it a night, okay?
Yeah, I got... Hey.
Hmm?
Look at that.
Yeah. Kind of late for anyone to be huddled in a doorway.
Let's have a peek in here, man. Stay here and cover me, Sarge.
Right, Ed.
Hey, buddy. We're police officers.
That's far enough, copper.
Watch him!
All right, take it easy. Yeah, what do you want?
It's me, Slim. Open up.
Oh. How many times do I have to tell you? 5 o'clock in the morning, I'm asleep
Yeah. I was in the neighborhood, Vicky.
Well, it's a fine reason.
Well, I'm in a jam. I want to stay here a few hours.
What kind of a jam?
The worst kind. Believe me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.